Hello, I'm the Budget Modeler and this is episode 6 of my King Tiger and Berg Panzer diorama build. If you're watching this, then please subscribe to my channel, give the video a like and ring my bell. That'd be brill. Thank you. In today's video, I'll be putting the side internal walls in, breaking parts that are already glued in, and lots more of the internal parts. So without further ado, let's crank up the speedy uppy thing and crack on. There we go, that's one side in. Now for the second side. This one took a little bit more fettling to get in. I say little. There we go, that's done, both sides are in. Now for more of the internals like pedals and supports and bits and pieces like that. Okay, here's a torsion bar, these are ready to be fitted in a bit, but first the rear plate and then a cross member. What could possibly go wrong, eh? Right, that cross member and rear plate are done. Now to fit the torsion bars. There we go, that's the torsion bars fitted. Can anyone spot the deliberate mistake yet? If you can, please pop what you think it is in the comments and also let me know why. Also, what really did my head in was the fact that one side of the arms on the torsion bars face forward and the other side face backwards. Talk about a complete and utter head. there's the torsion bars done. Now for the internal side of the escape hatch. There we go, one escape hatch in situ. Now for more of the internals. As you can probably guess, there are lots of internal parts to this kit. There are a few glaring holes on these storage containers, so it's out with a trusty sprue glue. Now for a bit of PE. And out with Mr. PE Bendy Tool. There we go. Lots of internals done, glued in place or ready for priming. Lots of stowage prepped, ready for priming. And on that note, thank you for watching episode 6. If you want to see what happens in episode 7, please subscribe to my channel, help it grow, like the video and ring my bell. Remember folks, stay safe, keep on modelling.